out here August 14th mowing the third cutting hay. About 5 weeks ago, actually 5 weeks ago today, I mowed the second cutting. Hardly any rain between then and now, and it sure don't make a very good third cutting. Got a chance of rain late tomorrow, scattered thunderstorms, and I think I'll probably get it up by tomorrow afternoon. But I wanted to get it cut because you can see how yellow it is. The aphids have been on it, eating the leaves. Don't like to see that. Stuff getting tossed around a lot by the reel. Missing the crimp on a little of it, but just a little. I don't think it's going to need to be crimped. This is about to get over here. There's my brother. Keep trying to get him put it in a truck pull, but he won't quite do it. I told him I'd buy the U-joint if it breaks it, but oh well. Gotta have some fun. Anyway, about right here is about how tall it was for fourth cutting last year. I'm guessing that, but on 3 acres, I think I had like 70 bales last year. If I have 55, I'll be surprised this year. It's not going to make much. The first about outside four rounds are just pitiful for whatever reason, especially back along the corn. Started in wondering why I was even wasting my time mowing it. Back in 2012, second year I had cattle, second year we done hay. Had fourth cutting, it was dry as a desert that year. Had a whopping 15 bales on the whole 3 acres. Talk about the short hay, premium hay, dark green, fine stem, deer alfalfa, but sure wasn't much of it. Probably could have still made some decent money because there was, you know, hay, good hay had gotten up to $12 or $13 for a 50-pound bale that year just because it was so dry, there was a shortage of it. I doubt I'll take a fourth cutting just because there won't be much out here, probably won't even be worth running over. If we get some rain, I might try to though. I took the shields off the back of it because the ground's so dry. I wanted to leave as wide of windrow as possible. Try to get it up tomorrow. for watching.